What's going on, people? It's your boy Charlie Box, the Patriotic Miscreant. And what I'm going to do today is see if Californians could still have an adult conversations without getting their feelings hurt. Let's see how easy this is. Hey, what's going on? Anybody trying to look for somebody to have an adult conversation? Can anybody have an adult conversation about stuff that people probably don't want to talk about because of political correctness? Can you just be candid and honest with yourself and America?
I kind of want to. We're going to come back in a second. So
all right. All right. That guy just had a lot of makeup on. What's going on? Hey, how you guys doing today? I'm trying to look for somebody to have an adult conversation. Yeah, you guys can. All right. An adult conversation. Hello, hey, I'm trying to look for anybody that's willing to have an adult conversation. Anybody willing to do that with me today? I don't think it's going to be this easy, people. People don't want to have an adult conversation today in America. Hey, gentlemen, I'm trying to look for somebody to have an adult conversation.
Nah.
Anybody have an adult conversation? All right.
Good one, man.
Next time. Hopefully some fish will bite. For right now, ain't no fish biting. Excuse me, I'm trying to look for someone to have an adult conversation with. Is there anybody willing to have an adult conversation with me? I just need to ask Americans questions. I think because of political correctness, we can't speak our mind. Well, I'm trying to give people that platform to do that. Check it out. Yeah, I'm trying to look for somebody to have an adult conversation with me. Mainly, I do videos just myself reporting like the news, but it's a lot of people here, so I just want to see if anybody would have an adult conversation. All right, take it easy.
Yeah, would you be interested in more parks and arts in our community?
No.
Take about 5 minutes to sign a petition.
Ooh, yeah. No, thanks.
All right, thank you. Have a good night.
Gotta get that food.
How about an adult conversation? I'm trying to look for someone to have an adult conversation with.
I am not an adult.
All right, that's a good answer. Yeah, that's it. Look at all these hoodlums on skateboards. Okay, we got a bunch of hoodlums on skateboards. No, I'm just kidding. They're just good kids. I'm trying to look for someone to have an adult conversation. Anybody willing to have an adult conversation? I'm trying to look for someone willing to have an adult conversation. Anybody willing to have an adult conversation? I'm trying today to have an adult conversation. Anybody willing to have an adult conversation with me? Anybody? Is anybody willing to have an adult conversation with me? I would like to have an adult conversation with somebody. Is there anybody willing to have an adult conversation? Well, I think because of political correctness today, we can't really speak our minds and be real with one another. Okay. You guys are, how old are you guys?
23.
21. 22. Okay. Today, California is a sanctuary state. Okay, that means we're willing to let illegal immigrants come into our community and live amongst us and look for the jobs that people like your age are just starting out to go get a job. How do you guys feel about that?
I mean, honestly, I feel like it just comes down to determination and wanting to succeed in whatever category you're working in, whether you're an 18-year-old barely trying to go into the workforce or a veteran immigrant that's 40, 50 years old wanting to get a job. I mean, at the end of the day, it comes down to who wants it more, I feel like. I mean, there's jobs out there for everybody. There's never going to be a lack of jobs. There's always something to do. It's just a matter of wanting to do it. Like, you can go wash dumpsters for a living. You can go do trash cans, janitorial services for a living. But I feel like there's people that are around our age where they don't necessarily want to do those kinds of jobs, but then find it wrong somehow when somebody that's older that wants to do it, but because they're undocumented or because they're illegal, it's somehow wrong for them to have that job versus somebody that is legal and younger to have that job. I don't know if that makes sense.
Okay. Well, today, okay, how our government officials are putting illegal immigrants' rights before an American rights. Do you happen to know where rights come from?
I mean, just from the general consensus of what the government allows us to do, right? I mean, I feel like that's a pretty broad statement to ask.
Well, see, one thing that I always said was, how do you take something from somebody without them knowing it? Well, don't teach it to them. We don't live in a democracy. There's a difference between a democracy and a republic. A republic, there's responsibility to the citizens to uphold it, because it says that man was granted these rights by God, their creator, not by government, because if you're willing to let government grant you rights, they're going to take them away. And see, today, as we become a sanctuary state, they're putting immigrants before Americans. You don't think there's nothing wrong with that?
I mean, I don't necessarily think that that's 100% true at the same time. I mean, in some aspects it is, in some aspects it's not. I just feel like it depends on what you're actually looking at, whether it comes down to employment or, you know, benefits or whatever the case may be. Because, I mean, there's people that are, you know, they do live in California. They are legal citizens getting government help and stuff like that, versus people that are illegal that aren't able to get those same benefits for whatever reason, you know. So I think it's like, it's definitely a give take with either or situation, whether you are legal or illegal, because I mean, at the end of the day, this almost all the same opportunities are presented to anybody that I feel like would be legal or illegal. I mean, looking at like the Dream Act, like, you know, Dreamers, all that stuff, I feel like it all goes hand in hand, where I don't think that it's like, I definitely think that there's certain situations in which an illegal person of the state shouldn't be granted the same exact options or opportunities as somebody that's illegal. But at the same time, I feel like it's such a small margin that it shouldn't be like compared as much. I don't know if that makes sense as well.
Well, okay, well, the Dreamers, those are kids that were undocumented. Their parents came over here. Yeah. They broke the law. Not the kids, but the parents did. Okay, even Trump said they wanted to legalize all the Dreamers. But the Democrats said, no, we want all illegal immigrant. What do you think about that?
I mean, I feel like if you're here for the right reasons, I think that being granted citizenship shouldn't be an issue. I mean, the whole consensus of the United States is that, I mean, really, the United States is kind of like a sanctuary for everybody, and that's kind of like historically what the United States is known for. Me personally, and seeing people my age and listening to people and seeing their political standpoints is kind of like Trump is taking that away and taking that identity away from the United States. And that's all 100% opinion based. Yeah. I agree on some portions of it. I disagree on some portions of it. But like I said, it depends on what exact, you know, margin you're looking at, because, you know, his travel ban and all that stuff, that could be considered like, hey, he's taking away that sanctuary, you know, demographic of the United States versus, you know, allowing people to come and allowing people to get citizenship and stuff like that. So
today it's $1 billion debt that the American people hold on our back. So whenever we allow women and children, most of those are going to be dependent on the system at the beginning because they need some kind of substance as soon as they get here. But they're not just allowing women and children, and they're letting men at the same time. Have you ever heard of the cloud and pivot strategy?
I have not.
The cloud and pivot strategy is to overwhelm the system. You put as many people upon the system, and then it collapses upon itself because you're taking more people from it than are giving into it. And I think that's what's going on today. So what makes America different than Mexico? America has prospered as a nation of 250 years, unlike the world has ever seen before. Mexico is just south of us. They're our neighbor. They've always been there. Why do you think Mexico isn't as prosperous as America?
I mean, I think it has a lot to do with commercialization as well. I mean, it really depends on resources as well. I mean, it all really goes back to, I mean, it's like a butterfly effect thing. It could be where one single action in the history of Mexico could have been different, and it could have been better than the United States, or vice versa, where one single action that the United States took, you know, in the past could change, and they could be one of the worst economies in the world. We could be a third world country as well, you know what I mean? So it all depends.
We'll be done. I want to thank you for your time. I appreciate it. I thank you for, because trust me, I've been asking a lot of people. Nobody gets the time to do it. My name is Charlie in the Box. If you want to check out the video, go up on Live Leak or YouTube later on, and maybe in a week or so.
Awesome.
But nice to meet you guys.
Thank you so much.
All right. See, at least the dude had an adult conversation. I could respect that. I really do. I respect that. Because how many other people just won't even stop? I'm not going to give up on people. Still going to ask a few more out of the hundreds of people that are out of here, if not thousands. There's, look at that. I'm asking Americans, are you willing to have an adult conversation? Anybody willing to have an adult conversation with me right now? It's all right. I understand. Called apathy. It's a horrible thing, people.
There's nothing you can do about it, just the way it is.
Can't hurt somebody's feelings, political correctness. Gotta get out of here with that shit.